Hey guys, the Buttons and the Martins want to welcome you to a virtual barn dance. We're so glad you're here with us this evening to kind of keep things rolling at home.
We know that this does not replace anything that you could do in person here with us, but we're so excited to share this with you guys online.
We just want to keep the spirit of the barn dances alive while we're apart. So push your couches aside, get your boots on, and get out on your dance floor.
Thanks for joining us here at Sycamore Creek.
Hey guys, again, just thankful you guys are joining us. Again, my wife Caitlin, I'm Adam Martin, and we're going to be teaching you a couple songs. One that we always teach out here at Sycamore Creek Family Ranch is just the simple Texas two-step, right? This is one of my favorites because you actually get to dance with a pretty lady. So all you got to do is find yourself a pretty lady. I always like to start off by asking her to dance, right? Don't just assume she's going to say yes, even though you may be in your living room, but say, hey, may I have this dance? Remember, fellas, right hand. You grab her right hand, one quick little spin, and then her completely straight right arm is in your slightly bent shoulder height left hand. The good thing about this, guys, is you can press pause at any moment and practice it as we're teaching it, all right? So this is the tough part. Like I was telling you, you always want to make sure you face your partner. Then your right hand, fellas, goes on the middle of the small of her back, and ladies, you place your left hand on his huge trapezius. It's that gigantic muscle between his neck and his shoulders. Fellas, let him know it's there. After all that COVID, 19 pounds you've gained, you still have those trapezius, hopefully. All right, so here's where you are. You want to make sure you're always facing towards your partner. We're never stepping side to side when we two-step. We're always dancing toward our partner or away from our partner, okay? It's a really simple step. We start with a, fellas, I'm going to be teaching you. So we're going to start with that left foot. Ladies, just mirror what I'm saying, right? You're smart enough to do it. Fellas, I'm going to speak directly to you because I know this is hard. All right. Fellas, you're going to take a left together, right together, left together, left together, right together, left. Pretty simple, right? Just keep those movements going towards your partner and also away. Left together, right together. One and two and one. One and two and one. Okay, couple things I want you guys to practice. I don't want you taking gigantic steps, right? What that's going to end up doing is you stepping on her boots. I don't know if you have boots on, but you should get boots on, ladies, because he may step on your boots, all right? So don't take big steps. They call it boot scooting for a reason. You're just nice and easy, just shuffling those feet, right? We're not in a race, okay? Like I said earlier, always want to be stepping toward or away from your partner, and we want to try to avoid the bobbing when we're dancing, right? We don't want to jump up and down. Let your feet do the work, and you're just sliding across that living room floor, right? And again, one thing I want to encourage you guys with specifically, right? This is practice. Practice makes perfect. My wife and I have been dancing for over 10 years together, and that's why we've learned. She can anticipate what I'm going to do, and I kind of have a similar rhythm, right? The more you dance together, the more comfortable y'all are going to get. So I just want to encourage you guys, just practice. You're not going to be an expert right off the bat. It's not going to be, as smooth as maybe the lady would like. So ladies, let the fella lead, right? Let him lead. Let him figure it out. All right. So we're going to go ahead and practice. Press play on that music. And here we go with George Strait, I Just Want to Dance With You.
To hesitate and be too shy, way too late. I don't care what they say other lovers do, I just want to dance with you. I got a feeling that you have a heart like mine, so let it show, let it shine. If we have a chance to make one heart of two, I just want to dance with you. I want to dance with you, twirl you all around the floor. That's what they intended dancing for. I just want to dance with you.
All right, let's go ahead and pause it right there, Right, guys, as we reach a point, right, where we've made our way around the living room once or twice, I am always dancing toward my partner or away from my partner. We want to make sure that we spice it up a little bit, right? If we've been sitting on the couch watching TV, now we're up interacting with our special someone, right? And so that we need to make sure we keep it fun on the dance floor as well. So as we're dancing around, right, we want to make sure that she doesn't get distracted with her phone, by the kids, you know, whatever else that you may have going on. So you got to keep her attention on you. And how you do that is maybe take her attention off, right? The kids are crying over here. There's something going on, right? All you got to do is just a little twist, right? And she can't see the kids anymore, right? Her focus is now back on you, right? And you just keep moving around that living room as you dance with, you know, and oh, there's something going on over there. So you just do a little twist back this way. So how we do those twists, right? We always want to make sure, again, fellas, as I'm teaching, I'm going to be teaching you this, as we do those twists, we want to make sure we lead our partner well. So we always want to indicate the twist by the hand that you're holding and the hand behind the back. I'm going to indicate it by ever so slightly opening up the position, and then I'm going to step around with my left, around with my left, and then back with my right. That's the 1-2-1. Let's try that again. Going this way this time. So we're going to go left together, right together. I'm going to indicate the twist, right? Step around together. We're already going the opposite way now, and back together. And 1 together, 2 together, 1 together. This is one of those that's actually going to take a little practice for y'all to get to be smooth, right? So when you just float around the dance floor and you can just really easily twist, and now I'm dancing away from my partner, right? Still try to keep in that counterclockwise motion, right? And as I twist back the other way, we just keep dancing in that counterclockwise motion. How you twist going backwards, right? You twist on the 1 versus the 2. So you'll, and again, indicate that you're going to be twisting by opening up that position, and fellas, you just pivot on that right foot, twist all the way around on the 1, and there's the 1 together, 2 together, 1 together. One more time going back the other way. Okay, so we're going left, that's 1, that's 2, that's 1. You're gonna pivot with that right, that's the 1, twist all the way around, 1 together, 2 together, 1 together. Okay? And again, the goal is to practice this where you can easily do it with a really smooth motion. And eventually, where you, as you're dancing around, you can go 1 full time all the way around, right? And dance backwards, and you can go 1 full all the way around. And again, the more you practice, the easier that one gets. If you're getting frustrated at home, right? This is, I can't get it, I keep stepping on her toes or whatever, you can make it real simple. As you're dancing around that living room, you just ever so gently pick her up, twist, and set her back down. Kids, right? No distraction anymore, and you just keep on dancing. So let's practice that once or twice as the song plays.
I wanna dance with you. Hold you in my arms once more. That's what they invented dancing for. And I just wanna dance with you. I caught you looking at me when I looked at you. Yes, I did. Ain't that true? You won't get embarrassed by the things I do. I just wanna dance with you. Oh, the boys are playing softly and the girls are too. So am I and so are you. If this was a movie, we'd be right on cue. I just wanna dance with you. I wanna dance with you. Twirl you all around the floor. That's what they intended dancing for. And I just wanna dance with you. I wanna dance with you.
All right, looking good, guys. The practice there was awesome. Well done on that. Awesome, awesome. All right, so now, again, after you've practiced a little bit of the twist, feel free to rewind it. Feel free to keep practicing that. We want to move on to some spins. We're going to actually teach a few spins here right now so that you guys, I know this is a lot of times hard for us to teach in the big barn setting, so this is actually a huge advantage that you get to learn some fun spins and get to practice them over and over and over again, right, as you just click that back button or 15 seconds back or whatever it is. So we're going to teach a couple real simple ones to start off and then a couple advanced ones for you guys to practice at home so that when we get back together out here, you can show us what you've been learning. All right, so again, in the dance position, I'm always facing toward my partner. What I want to make sure I do is always let the lady spin first. I indicate that by lifting my left hand, her right hand. She spins out. I gently push her away, right? We're always facing toward our partner, right? We're holding that hand. We never let go of that hand. And I'm basically going to go where she is, and she is going to come where I am. We're just going to trade places. How we do that is by our right foots stepping toward one another. Make sure your pinky toes are closest. Don't step where your big toes are closest to each other, but your pinky toes, right? I'm going again where she is. She's coming where I am. And I'm just going to move my left arm across my body. Fellas, I'm just going to walk around behind her. She's going to spin one time, and we trade places. Again, arms are extended. She's where I was. I'm where she was. All right. So let's try that one more time a little faster. Step toward the partner. Arm comes across, and she spins. Great job. One more time faster. Arms across. She spins. Fellas, it's your turn to show your spinning abilities. What you want to do is take that left hand. That's the only thing that's different. Still step toward your partner. Left hand comes out. Ladies, I know you love spinning. Don't spin this time. You're just going to walk around behind as he dips his cowboy hat underneath, and you trade places. Again, one more time. Step, dip, underneath. Fellas, a good combo one is if you spin her, right? She spins across, but you spin right after. An easier way to do that, if there's a big height difference between the girl and the guy, is guys, you can do a low arm spin. What that looks like is as you spin, it's the same thing. Your arm comes out, but instead of dipping underneath, you leave the arm down, right? And let her hand slide across the small of your back and catch it with that same left hand on the other side. We'll show you that one more time. So you step towards your partner, you change places, arm slides across your back, and you catch it on the same side. It looks like this when you combine it with her upspin and then my downspin. It's a really simple and smooth combination. So those are some really easy spins. Again, this is your opportunity to be creative, right? She can spin once. Fellas, you can, you know, spin twice if you want. She can spin twice. Right? There's lots of different ways to combine all of these spins as you're moving around the dance floor, still in that counterclockwise motion. Okay, also what you want to do is you don't want to spin the entire song, right? You don't want to get her too dizzy, but as she is the, you know, you're done spinning and you want to bring her back in, fellas, all you have to do is just stand still, and as you spin her in, you then place your hand back on the small of her back. She places her hand back on your trapezius, and you keep moving around the dance floor, right? So real time, here's what that looks like, right? So she spins out, right? She spins once or twice. You can spin once or twice, and then you're right back in to the dance position. All right, so let's go ahead and practice a couple spins as we're moving around the dance floor. I just wanna dance with you. We're going to go ahead and pause it right there. As the end of the song is coming up, you always want to make sure you end well, right? We don't want to just ever say, hey, here's the end of the song. All right, peace out, you know, and then go back to to watching whatever TV show you're watching. You want to make sure you end well with that end of the song. So here's how we're going to do that. As you hear the end of the song coming, you're in the dance position. You maybe just got done spinning or twisting or whatever it is that you were just doing. So as the end of the song is coming, you want to gently just spin her out one time, spin her back in twice, and dip her across the body. Notice that her left foot is behind her right knee, right? And she is not just throwing herself backwards hoping that I catch her, right? And we're also not dipping her away from me, right? Where her left hip is touching my right hip, right? We never want to dip away because she will end up on the floor or on the couch or wherever it is. You want to make sure her right hip is touching your right hip and you dip across the body. Right here, the center of gravity is here. I have her. She's totally fine. She's not going anywhere. Okay? So nice and easy. Here we go. We're going to practice this in the dance position, right? Hand in the middle of the small of her back. She spins out. Give her a quick little wink, oh, hey. Right? She spins back in, not once, but twice, right back in the dance position. Fellas, I just step out, right hip to right hip, and she dips across my body. Perfect. Let's try that real time with the music playing. End of the song is right around the corner, so here we go.
I just want to dance with you. I just want to dance with you.
She spins out. She spins back in, not once, but twice. And dip. Guys, again, thank you so much for joining us for a little Texas two-step. Stick around for a few more songs. Guys and gals, thank you for joining us. Caitlin Martin, Adam Martin here at the Sycamore Creek Family Ranch is going to teach you a little polka and some faster spin moves. Actually, one of our favorite that we enjoy doing together. Okay, so we're going to dance this song to Chris Stapleton, Parachute, one of my personal favorite songs. And we'll cue it up for you here in just a second. So again, the only difference, if you just got done watching our two-step video, I would encourage you to watch that first. It goes through a lot of the basics on frame and how to actually dance with your partner. This is a little bit different frame that you can do. Instead of hand on the middle of the small of her back, again, you will do the left hand, shoulder height, all that stuff, but you'll place your right hand over her right shoulder and then just put your hand right here in the middle of her back. Ladies, instead of putting your hand all the way on his shoulder, you'll just rest it on his giant bicep right there, right? Let him know it's there, fellas. That's what we're, yep, All right, so as we're dancing in this position, we're gonna do basically the same thing as the two-step, except we're gonna take two steps with both feet. So we're gonna go left together, right together, right together. The reason why you do a polka is because it's typically to faster beat songs, right? Two steps are a little bit slower, smoother, kind of a 2 to 3 beat song. The polka is that consistent 4 beat faster song. So here's what you don't want to do. You certainly don't want to be taking big steps. If you take big steps, you're not going to be able to actually keep up with the beat of the song. So just nice and easy, smooth, boot, scoot, and step. So a little one together, two together. Left together, right together, one, two, one, two. Ladies, just emulate whatever the guy's doing, except just switch those feet, right? It's important too, always let the guy lead. You're only gonna be as good of a dancer as he is going to be leading you. So let him lead, don't try to take control, and practice makes perfect. So as you're dancing around, I still want you to do the spins, I still want you to do twists, all of those things, but just to the faster beat song. Little left together, right together, right together. And as you twist around the dance floor, you just keep that 1-2 moving, okay? And we'll actually teach the more fun, a little bit more advanced spin here in just a second. So we'll go ahead and start off with the beginning of that song, and you can practice with us doing a little polka.
Shadows in the dark, and the memories keep on turning to the rhythm of a broken heart. You're in the room for the training. You
Great job, guys. A few things you want to avoid. You know your feet are there. You know what they're doing. You don't need to stare down at them the whole time. Every now and again, look up at your beautiful dance partner. Smile at them a little bit. Maybe even talk to them. Hey, how are things going, right? What do you think about this? Whatever it is. Maybe a little bit better than I just did. Whatever it is, maybe try to have a conversation. It helps take off of the stress of trying to be perfect with the feet, right? Notice that my wife and I did a lot of twists while we're doing this. We love to twist as we're doing the polka, right? And there's pressure on this hand as we're twisting. So as we're moving around the dance floor, I lean back, she leans back a little bit, and that pressure helps us with the spin. Make sure you keep, or the twist, make sure you keep that one together, two together beat going. So a little one together, two together, one together, two together, one together, two together, one together, two together. And you can just spin a lot. This is actually one of my favorite things to do with Caitlin, is this type spin to a faster polka, right? And you can really kind of get into it with that spin. And the faster you spin, the more pressure there will be, right? Don't do too much where you're flying around the room, but just keep your feet nice and steady. All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and transition into some really fun spins, one of our favorites, right? We'll go ahead and show you first, and then we'll teach you how to do it. So again, always facing the dance partner. There's a part of the song that maybe midway through or whatnot, you're ready to show off a little bit, right? You're dancing around. She spins out. You grab both hands. She spins into your right shoulder. She comes around. She unwinds once. I step around behind. She unwinds twice. I step around behind. And then the last time, I let go right back in to the dance position. All right? So let's go ahead and learn that. There's an intro to this, and there's an actual continuous move. So there's kind of two parts to this, and we'll teach it separately. And feel free, if you need to, just to press pause and back up to make sure that you can nail this down. So again, in the dance position, she spins out like we start a lot of spins, but this one, what I do is I just immediately extend the other hand. I'm not gonna tell her, hey, we're about to do my favorite spin move, right? You don't do that. You just extend the hand and she learns, oh, this is what he's indicating, right? That's just one of those things where practice makes perfect. So once you're here, she's gonna spin into your right shoulder. So you take your left hand, bring it across just like you would a normal spin, and she comes into your right shoulder. You're standing side by side. Right, there's a lot of different things that you can do from here. I can reach around, I can grab her and flip her, right? I can, from this position, spin her out. There's lots of different things that you can do from this particular move. And again, I'm not gonna tell her, hey, this is the one, like, you just don't do that. I indicate each move differently. How I indicate this move is ever so slightly shoulder nudge, right? My shoulder nudge and my step with my right foot indicates to her she's not gonna step forward. Instead, all she's gonna do is just bend over at the waist, stay still, and her arms come through. I stay on that right foot. My right foot hasn't moved and it's not going to move. I pivot on that right foot until the hands come to the left shoulder, okay? So once you're here, make sure your hands never let go. So keep your hands together on that left shoulder. You never let go. Now, fellas, you stay still. Ladies, you come around in front, you lift the hand up, and you just unwind to your right, right? This is where the continuous move starts. We call it the teeter-totter. As one hand comes down, the other hand comes up, and she still is spinning to her right, right? She has not stopped spinning to her right this entire time. So now, once she's facing me again, right, that's when we stop, right? I'm gonna step through, and a good way to do this, guys, that part where the girl's hand can come behind her back can be a little weird. So what we wanna do is what I say, to avoid breaking the wrist, you wanna break the wrist. By doing that, what I mean by that is you just, as you unwind, right, you just ever so gently rotate her hand in, which easily allows her to put her hand behind her back and also indicates her to spin. I'm not spinning her by winding her around, right? That's not how we spin. Right, we spin by holding the hand still, and she just knows which way to go. Okay, so we break the wrist. I step around with one. She stays still. I step with my right foot underneath, right foot behind, left foot back underneath. And notice there was also a teeter-totter, right? When I stepped through, her right hand was up. As I stepped behind, her left hand goes, her right hand goes down and her left hand comes up. And I step back underneath, right? I'm not twisting, I'm not turning, I'm just walking around behind her, okay? So as I step behind and back underneath, she has the ability to spin twice right here. So right hand, her left hand is up, my right hand is up. I'm going to indicate for her to spin, right? There's one spin, right hand down, left hand up, and there's two spins. So she does two full spins with us standing right here. She's not going to spin over there. She's not going to spin over here. She and I are going to stay square and spin that way. So as I step around behind again a second time, right, two more full spins, and then I end it by once I step through, I let go with my right hand, and then I bring her back into the dance position, or I spin her back into the dance position, either or, okay? And so then we keep dancing. At this point, we would keep dancing in the counterclockwise motion. All right, so again, so from the very beginning, there's two different ways. We can start this one, if we wanted to, with a continuous move. Hands right here, right hand down, left hand up, and we can just start right in the middle of that, right? But that's not a really good intro into that dance. The better intro, like I showed you earlier, is by indicating with her spinning into your right shoulder, right? You indicating with that right shoulder that you are going to take that big step. She puts her arms through. She comes around and she unwinds once, twice. She's facing you. I step around once, and then she spins twice again. I let go, which indicates that we're done with the move, and we jump back into the dance position and keep dancing. This is one that's going to take you a couple times to get. We're going to go ahead and press play. We're going to dance a little bit. We're going to show you real time what it looks like to a song, and then we'll stop and teach you one more really fun one. Go. We got a couple times in. Hopefully you guys had a chance to practice some of that. We're going to show you another one of my favorites. And this one is going to be a little bit harder for those of you that have the cowboy hat on, but we will make it. All right. So here's what we're going to do. As we're dancing around the dance floor, right, we've maybe shown off maybe our favorite one. We're going to show off something a little bit more complicated, but also equally as fun. So what we're going to do is as our partner spins out, we're going to indicate this move by just shaking her hand. Okay, so as we shake her hand, we're going to show that we want to grab the other hand, her left hand with your left hand. Yep, is that right? Yeah, there we go. Her left hand with your left hand underneath. So right hand to right hand, left hand to left hand. And she's going to start off with just a spin. She's going to spin to her right, right? And she's going to spin around one time. Again, make sure you gently break that wrist so it goes behind her back. And as my arm comes across, she's going to create a window right here. This little window, I have to fit my cowboy hat through, okay? So as this window is created, I'm going to dip down underneath. I'm going to walk around behind, and I'm going to come back under the window on the other side. So it's similar to what we did the last time, right? Except of me just walking around behind, which I can't do with my hands like this. I have to dip down underneath, step around, and come back underneath, right? So again, from the beginning, she spins out. I grab right hand to right hand like we're shaking hands, hand underneath. She spins around, creates that window. I step underneath and I come back around underneath. Here's the fun part for the ladies. Ladies, you bend over, you keep your hands still, and your hands kind of stay in the middle of the small of your back. She spins all the way around. She keeps spinning, keeps spinning, keeps spinning, keeps spinning. She stands back up, and we're right back where we began, right? We're now on the left side instead of the right side again, okay? Instead of me stepping back underneath, we're going to go back around just like we started. Again, right hand to right hand, left hand to left hand. Now it's my turn as the fellow to show off my spinning abilities, right? So I'm going to spin to the right, fellas, just like I did with her. My arm is going to break behind my back, and I'm going to show the window for her to step through right here, okay? She's going to bend over. She's going to step through, come back around, and come back under the window on the other side, right? How we get back to the beginning, instead of me her going back through, what I'm going to do, just like before, I cross my feet when I do this, but I cross my feet, I bend over, and I spin all the way around. And instead of continuing to go as the fella, I encourage you just to stop right here. Once you get to her, go ahead and stop, let go of her hands, and then just come right up. Her hands slide across the small of your back, and you catch them coming out the other side, right? So let's do that again. Right hand to right hand, fella, it's your turn, right? So go ahead and spin to your right, which creates the window for her. She steps through, she comes back underneath, and as soon as she comes back underneath, I'm already spinning. I stop right here, and boom, we catch coming up the other side, and we continue to dance around the dance floor. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and press play, and we will show you how that looks real time. Just know. Guys, thank you so much for watching our polka video, some of the dips and spins. Thankful that you guys are here. Stick around for a few more. Guys, welcome to the Sycamore Creek Family Ranch. Caitlin and Adam here to teach you the Copperhead Road. This is one of our favorite line dances because it's so simple, right? There's a little bit of an energy kick up at the end, but it's a really simple line dance. I know there's lots of different versions out there, but this is the one that we have learned, and it's pretty easy to teach adults, kiddos, and everybody alike. So, as the song starts, right, there's a little bit of a rough start to it. You got to make sure you start on time, but the dance itself is really easy. Anytime you're line dancing, you're not really sure what to do with your hands. I always tell people, put your thumbs in your pockets, right? Your pants should be too tight in order for you to put your whole hand in there. So just put your thumb, right? If you can fit your whole hand, you need to get tighter jeans. All right, so go ahead with your thumbs in your pockets. You're going to start with that right foot. Right, left, right, left. Really simple, right? That's the first part. So right, left, you're going to take that right foot. This is the second part. Go out, over, out, down. Left foot, out, over, out, down. Let's combine all those. Let's combine those two parts together. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, left, right, left, and out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down. Part three is the same as part one. Right, left, right, left. Here's part four. This is the fun part. You take that right foot just like you would when you're a really good bowler, right? And you kind of kick that left foot up, right? You're not going to do that goofy thing with your hand, but instead you're going to stomp with that right foot, kick that left foot up. You can be like mediocre kick, or you can really get into it and really kick that foot, right? And that just shows how good of a dancer you are, right? So you're going to kick that left foot, that stomp, 2, 3, 4. You're going to slowly turn to your left. This is a four-wall line dance. So we're each going to face all four walls throughout the line dance, all right? So we're going to ever so slightly turn in the two times we stomp to our left, 45 degrees, all right? So we're facing forward. This is part four. We're going to stomp, 2, 3, 4, stomp, 2, 3, 4. We're facing 45 degrees to our left. Start over with the right, left, right, left, out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down, right, left, right, left, and stomp, 2, 3, 4, stomp, 2, 3, 4, right, left, right, left, out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down, right, left, and stomp, 2, 3, 4, stomp, 2, 3, 4, one more time, right, left, out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down, right, left, and stomp, 2, 3, 4, stomp, 2, 3, 4. We faced all four walls throughout that song. What we're going to do also, as the music kicks up a little bit, eventually we're not going to just go right, left. Eventually, right, you're going to need a little bit more space, and you're going to need to go right, bounce, left, bounce, right, bounce, left, bounce, out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down. Keep the energy up. It's hard to talk while you're doing this. Bounce, 2, 3, 4, stomp, 2, 3, 4, right? Really get into those stomps as the music kicks up a little bit. All right, here we go, Sycamore Creek. I don't know if I'm going to be able to talk at all after this, but we're going to try a little Copperhead Road. All right, like I said earlier, this is a little bit of a weird song to start to, right? You hear some music already playing. I'm gonna go ahead and start where you can see me facing this way. You wanna be ready with that right foot. I'm gonna try to count it off in 5, 4, 3, 2, left, right, left, out, over, out, down, out, over, out, down, right, left, right, left, and stomp, stomp.
Well, my name's John Lee Pettimore. Same as my daddy and his daddy before. You hardly ever saw granddaddy down here.
Remember, you don't want to start off too crazy. It's going to get crazy at the end. You're going to save your energy. I don't think I've ever done a line dance all by myself.
Everybody knew that it made me shine. I'm a revenue man, want a granddaddy bad. Head left a holler, everything had. For my time, but I've been told to never come back from Copperhead Road.
And remember, you can get as crazy as you want with those stomps. Out, over, out. It's a little weird not watching other people do it with you.
Shots of cannon share painting on the side. Just shot a coat of primer and looked inside. Well, him and my uncle tore that engine down. I still remember that rumbling sound.
All right, the song is about to kick up. We're about to go to a different level here. Let me see if I can keep up with you. I think I missed up there. Right, left, right, left. Out, over. We'll go crazy on the next one. And right. Bounce left, bounce right, bounce left. All right, you heard the music kick up. And stomp, and stomp. is a great way to get energy out for those kiddos. It's a great way to work off that COVID-19, right? Guys, I promise you, even if you know what you're doing, you mess up all the time. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. I think we're done with that one. I totally messed up like at least 3 times.
Yeah, guys, thanks for joining us and excited for you to keep updated with things going on here at the ranch. So join us on Facebook, Instagram, and make sure you check out the email list on the website at SycamoreCreekFamilyRanch.com. Thanks again.
Hey, thanks for joining us tonight, guys. We really hope you had a great time and enjoyed a little barn dancing with your family.
Stay healthy, stay hopeful, and we'll look forward to seeing you all here again soon.